Okay, it's, we're leaving at 6 a.m. I have to run to Marco Island to pick up 465. I'll fly 465 back. And we're waiting for the sun to come up, but we can't wait. We had 40 minutes to get to Marco Island, and it's not gonna happen. We're not gonna do that. That weather is predicted to go IFR, so we're gonna see what happens once we get there. And once we get there, and gonna play it by ear on how to get back. All right, so we made the decision. We're gonna drive and then see what happens when we get there. So we're gonna drive to Naples, Marco Island right now. So that's what we're doing right now. All right? Sometimes you gotta make the hard decisions, you know? You know, the weather's getting, when it comes to the weather, you don't play. When it comes to the weather, you don't play. So we're making the decision to drive. And then if I have to wait in Marco Island all day until it clears up to bring the other airplane back, that's what we're doing. So we're driving now, yeah. All right, so we're here in Marco Island, and as you can see, it's not going to get any better. It's not forecast to get any better, but it looks good right now. So we're going to shoot right across to Miami, Marco Island. There's the end of the runway down there. So we got the engine started, and we're ready to go. Even though I took off in the rain, visibility was still good, and that was what was most important. The ride was smooth, so as long as I could see ahead, that's all that mattered. I kept a watchful eye on the weather and even plotted my course directly towards Dade Kalia Airport. That would be my ultimate airport, just in case visibility dropped way lower than I needed or wanted it to. My indicated airspeed was way higher than my ground speed, which meant I had a headwind. Which is surprising because the weather was coming from the southwest and I was heading southeast. I could see from the radar and looking up ahead that I had a band of showers ahead of me, and it was in between me and Dade Kalia Airport, but I knew once I passed the Dade Kalia Airport, the weather would get considerably better. Hearing the rain hit the windshield made it seem a little bit more worse than it really was. Just as I expected, the weather got better after I passed Dade Kalia Airport. This is when I changed the GPS to fly directly towards Opa-locka, and I was getting the Opa-locka ATIS information at the same time, monitoring it as we flew. Even though Opa-locka was reporting the winds at nearly calm and 10 miles visibility, it was still raining, so I mentally prepared myself to land in the rain. Safely. As you can see now, Opa-locka is still overcast. Still a little bit of droplets. It's not really wet, not like it is out west, out there, but that stuff is still coming. So I was able to outfly it and get here safely. So everybody's waiting for me to get in. I gave them a little power rep. These guys in the service are getting ready to go now. They're gonna go out and play out on the beach for a little bit, but they don't have a lot of time because that stuff is coming. See that wall? Y'all see that gray wall? Well, y'all saw it. Y'all was with me. See that gray wall? That ain't no joke. It's Carlos, by the way. Sitting fly under. Y'all seen him in one of my previous videos.
How y'all doing?
So, yes, sir. And we're here. So, thank you guys for watching. I'll let you on the flip side.